Creating user-defined functions. So we'll start in the main application and clear everything out the way. I'm in decimal, real and degrees at the bottom here. Now, the first function is 1 on x. So let's simply enter 1 divide x up here and tap execute. And there's our function. But if we want to actually call it, use function notation here, there's a pretty simple way of doing this. So we're going to select the expression, tap on interactive define. And everything's pretty much ready to go. It's saying the function's going to be called f, the variable is x, and the expression is 1 on x. So when I tap OK, ClassPad completes the expression. And now we can I'll be pretty lazy here, drag a copy and evaluate, for instance, f of 5. And when I tap execute, it comes up as 0.2. I might want to solve an equation. So if I get the keyboard up and tap in, solve f of x, so let's steal that from up here, equal to, say, I think 0.25. Then when I tap execute, ClassPad solved it for 4. Now on the math 3 tab, we could also set up our functions this way. Here's the word define, here's f was one of the common names. We can use our brackets over here and the equals sign. So there's another way to actually define a function that way, and then it could be anything following it. Now let's look at a different type. So clear all. So regular kind of function work works kind of like that. We can also make sort of more unusual. Here's a conversion to convert kilometers per hour into meters per second. So say we've called this function K2M, and it's a straightforward unit converter. So here we go again. Now I'll actually start straight away from the define box this time. And our function name, we need to go to the ABC. When we're using or defining functions, make sure you always use the ABC keyboard. So kilometers to meters is our abbreviation for that. The variable can be x, and our expression is simply 10x divide 36. And when I tap OK, our function's been done. So to see it at work, we can come down to here and type in 100 and so that's roughly 27.8 meters per second. Another way of using it, suppose we've cleared everything out here and we want to go find our functions. If we tap down here to the catalog of functions and restrict the functions that we're going to see just to those made by the user. So here we go. And you can see today there are the two that we've made, the original function and the one we just embedded. Now we can either double tap on this word or simply tap on input to get the entry show up here. And again, maybe we want to convert 14 kilometers an hour to meters per second, tap execute 3.89.